Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining MPLS traffic engineering. In all of my explainer videos, I explain networking and telecom concepts in a way that I wish I had been taught when I was learning. And if you like that approach, then like, subscribe, and enable notifications to be among the first to view my newly published content. Before we look at traffic engineering for MPLS specifically, I'd like to first take a step back and talk a little bit about traffic engineering in general. When I first started learning, I was taught traffic engineering directly. They said, this is what it is, and this is what it does, and this is how you apply it. But the key element that was missing for me was the why. I don't know about you, but if I don't understand the why behind something, it's much harder for me to grasp and retain it. So why do we need traffic engineering? And under what circumstances do we need it? What problems does it solve? Traffic engineering, whether in the context of MPLS or other frameworks, is primarily a requirement in service provider networks, as well as extensively large data centers. You will rarely encounter MPLS traffic engineering even in large enterprise networks unless the enterprise operates an exceptionally huge and complex network. Now, the challenges that traffic engineering addresses tend to emerge only at scale. Now, by this I mean the needs of the network that necessitate TE are typically found in service provider networks that handle vast volumes of traffic. These providers aim to ensure their infrastructure is used as efficiently as possible because at these scales, having an idle, underused link can mean losing tens of thousands of dollars an hour or more. Yes, you heard right, tens of thousands of dollars an hour. At the same time, service providers aim to maintain the necessary redundancies, reliabilities, and quality of service for the traffic using their infrastructure. So in essence, traffic engineering seeks to optimize the efficiency, reliability, and quality of service of large-scale networks, ensuring as little network underutilization as possible. Now at the same time, TE safeguards the levels of service promised to its customers. It's a solution designed for networks with massive data flows shared among thousands of customers, where traditional routing, redundancy, and QoS techniques simply fall short of meeting the demands of scale, performance, and resource utilization. Now, just to let you know, TE as a concept is relevant not only to MPLS, but also to other types of infrastructures such as segment routing, software-defined networking, and BGP-based networks, as well as IGP infrastructures that leverage routing protocols such as OSPF or ISIS. So that's the why. Now, can we answer another question? What is traffic engineering? TE is composed of a whole series of techniques and methodologies that are used to achieve the why, namely, to achieve the optimization of efficiency and performance of the network. Now, TE is composed of the following key components. The first is path optimization. Now, TE ensures that traffic takes the most efficient paths through the network, avoiding overburdened links while directing traffic to less utilized links. Next is resource allocation. TE attempts to balance the use of network resources, such as bandwidth and CPU and memory, to prevent bottlenecks and to achieve optimal utilization. Now, the third component is quality of service enforcement. Now, here TE is used to prioritize certain types of traffic, for example, voice, video, or traffic that may belong to particular customers, to meet latency, jitter, packet loss, and other required network thresholds, all of which are usually defined within network SLAs, which are agreements between entities as to how their traffic is going to be handled. Then we have load balancing. Traffic is attempted to be distributed over multiple links or paths to achieve better infrastructure usage while preventing the overloading of a single resource. And finally, we have resilience and redundancy. Now, TE can reroute traffic automatically in case of a link or node failure, ensuring minimal disruption to traffic. Now, someone may say that we can achieve these things using more traditional methods. Someone may ask about normal routing. We can use the metric of a routing protocol to adjust the choice of the next hop of a particular route. We can even have equal cost load balancing across multiple paths that have the same metric. Isn't that enough? Well, the answer is yes, it's enough for enterprise networks, but it's not enough when you get to the scale of service provider networks and large data centers. At these scales, you want to have more granular control over the possible alternative paths that traffic can take place. The problem with routing protocols at these scales is that there are very few parameters we can use when it comes to metric. We can only use the single path with the lowest metric. We can't use any other available paths. There are cases, of course, where we can configure equal cost load balancing, where multiple paths can be used that have equal cost, but there isn't much more that you can do beyond that. On large service provider networks, you may have 1, 5, 10, or 30 alternative paths, each having a different metric based on the IGP. So just by using the metric of an IGP, the result is that you will unavoidably have underutilized or completely unused links, and that is unacceptable at scale. Now let's put all of this knowledge into perspective as we talk about MPLS traffic engineering. To optimize the efficiency of a network, it's necessary to determine and understand the current network conditions. This includes information such as which interfaces are heavily utilized, which are underutilized, and the available bandwidth that exists across the whole network. From this information, TE will be able to ensure that resources are allocated intelligently in order to maximize the performance and reliability. Now, MPLS traffic engineering employs a technique called constraint-based routing, which goes beyond traditional shortest path routing. Instead of simply choosing the shortest route, MPLS-TE selects paths that meet specific criteria that you as an administrator can define. These criteria can include a whole series of parameters, including bandwidth requirements, exclusion or inclusion of certain interfaces or nodes, or other policy-based constraints. Now, to direct traffic along these optimized paths, MPLS-TE establishes unidirectional tunnels called label-switched paths. These tunnels are configured from a source to a destination and can be designed to meet specific requirements, such as guaranteed bandwidth, particular link attributes, or traffic prioritization. For example, in a given network topology such as this one, you could configure Tunnel 1 here to carry packets marked with a particular DSCP value for real-time applications like voice, while Tunnel 2 could handle high-priority data traffic. Standard traffic, meanwhile, would continue to use the network's MPLS traffic switching mechanisms without any adjusted traffic engineering parameters. So by utilizing these LSPs, MPLS-TE ensures that traffic flows are aligned with network policies and performance goals. Each LSP acts as a unidirectional tunnel, specifically engineered for forwarding traffic that matches our granularly configured parameters from the defined source to the defined destination. Now, this initial introduction and description of MPLS-TE will hopefully provide you with a fundamental understanding of the why behind traffic engineering, as well as a deeper understanding of how it's applied and under what circumstances, as well as an introduction to how MPLS-TE operates at a very high level. In upcoming videos, we will dig deeper into MPLS-TE and we'll see how these features can be configured and applied in a service provider network. For now, I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. And if you have any questions or feedback, feel free to leave a comment. I'm always happy to read them and to respond. And please subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this video has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.